First Peter chapter 5 verse 8. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. Second Corinthians chapter 2 verse 11, and it's read, lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices. Honor, glory, power, or praises to Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi, for another day. Today is the second day of May 2022. We thank the Most High Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi, for watching over us in the month of April, and as we patiently wait for the coming of our Lord, our Redeemer, Yahawashi. Shalom, beloved. Let's get into it. I came across this article and from Tyranny News, and like the book says, lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices. This is one of the major prophecies mentioned in Revelation chapter 13 verse 16, and the Lord made it clear in Revelation 14 verse 9 to 10 what exactly is going to happen to his elect, anybody that takes this mark here. If you take this, you become a slave to the system for the rest of your life. That meaning what? You bow down to his image. That's right. They want to know everything about you. Basically, they want to play the Most High Yahawah, Bahasham Yahawashi. So once this thing goes into you, you are telling the Lord Yahawah that you rather worship the creature that he has created than worship him. That's why he says, yes, the angels and Yahawashi are going to watch you become a barbecue. That's right. This time, the world, especially aka Babylon, the great America, is not going to be destroyed with water. No, this time it's going to be missiles and the lasers coming from the chariots. That's why we're here to warn you. That's why it says in Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 17 and down, it's a son of man. Let me read a bit of it. Excuse me, and then I'll bring this out. I don't want this thing to be long, family. Son of man, son of man, son of man. It says, I think, somewhere in Ezekiel. Ezekiel 3:17. It says, let's read it. It says, son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore, hear the word at my mouth and give them warning from me. This is warning. This is warning. The Lord loves us so much that, family, he didn't leave anything to a complicated interpretation. No, he's telling us, he's making everything plain on the table for us. Eh? Plain. He's telling you, don't do A. If you do A, this is what's going to happen to you. Family, our trust is in our power, Yahawah Bahasham Yahawashi. Let's get into it. It says, microchip implanted in your hand. Why worried? This is from Tyranny News. I don't own this article. I don't own this website. It's just for edification only. Yeah, this was published on the 27th of April. Let's get into it, family. And I hope when it's all said and done, you are edified, family. The story at glance, it says implantable microchips are marketed as the ultimate in convenience. You see the word convenience? You know that our people love convenience. Family is getting so bad that, family, we can't even remember our family's phone numbers. Eh? Before the smartphone, family used to memorize numbers. Now, you put it in, that's it, you forget about it. And what does that do to our brains, family? Our people love convenience. Anyhow, let's continue. It says, but the goal is to create the internet of bodies described by the World Economic Forum as an ecosystem of an unprecedented number of senses, including emotional senses attached. Listen to this. Emotional senses attached to, implanted within or ingested into human bodies to monitor, analyze, and even modify human bodies and behavior. You see, they're trying to play the Most High. Habakkuk chapter 2. Let's hear what Habakkuk have to say. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 4. It says what? Behold, his soul, which is lifted up, is not upright in him. But the just, meaning the elect, shall live by his faith. Because this is what they are thinking. They're trying to play the Most High, Yahawah, Bahasham. The family, a lot of people are going to fall for it. Sweden is one of the earliest adopters of implantable microchips. The chip is implanted just beneath the skin, on the hand, and operates using either near-field communication, the same technology used in smartphones, or radio frequency identification, RFID, which is used in contactless credit cards. Implanted payment chips are an extension of the Internet of Things. They are a way of connecting and exchanging data, and the benefit must be weighed against the potential risk. Countries around the world are now working on a system for a central bank digital currency. That's why it says what? The hour of temptation is going to be what? Worldwide. Nobody's hiding. Everywhere you are, this is what you're going to be facing. That's right. It's going to be linked to your work. It's going to link to your account, your bank account. Everyday chores, things that we do. Your driver's license, your birth certificate, your health card. Yes. Everything is going to be linked together. And if you don't take it, you're not going to be part of the system. And family, we are not taking it. That's right, we are not taking it. We're going to put our trust in our power, Yahawah, Bahashem Yahawashi. He has not disappointed us yet. Why is he going to start now? He gave us his name. He gave us this beautiful song that we are singing right now. He put a new garment on us. Gave us our only begotten son. Sacrifice his son for us. These are the benefits that we have to meditate on. If the Most High Yahawah is for us, who can be against us? Who can be against us? Family, don't listen to these devils. They have no clue what is coming for them. Let's continue. Implanted payment chips are an extension of the Internet of Things. They are a way of connecting and exchanging data, and the benefit must be weighed against the potential risks. Countries around the world are now working on a system for central bank digital currency, CBDC, a flat currency in digital form that is programmable so that you can spend your money only on certain things or in specific places as desired by the issuer. In the end, everything will be connected to a single implantable. Listen to this, implantable device that will hold your digital identity, health data, and programmable CBDC. Your money, everything is going to be linked to it, family. Your digital identity in turn will include everything that can be known about you through surveillance via implanted biosensors, your computer, smartphones, GPS, social media, online searches, purchases, and spending habits. Algorithms will then decide what you can and cannot do based on who you are. Family, let's watch a quick video here.
By clicking on that button down here and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights.
I'm supposed to go back.
And digital exclusives. Thanks for watching.
What is that? Please bear with me. I don't know what happened. Yeah.
When okay. Elias Brotberger goes to work, he doesn't need ID. And he doesn't need money. In fact, much of what he needs to get through the day is hidden right there, just below the surface, in his hand.
You like to touch it?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Oh, weird. Yeah, it's like a grain of rice.
Yeah, a grain of rice.
Embedded in his hand is a microchip that serves as his keys, his ID, and his wallet.
Yeah, it's all in the chip, so I use it like to get around the building.
Buy snacks.
Yeah, exactly.
Let's buy some snacks. Exactly. So I can't open it.
No.
Okay.
So what I need to do is I need to first blip my chip, and it will log me in, mm-hmm. and from there I get access to the fridge.
Popular TV shows like Black Mirror have imagined chips as part of a dystopian future.
Install ingrain procedure with local anesthetic and you're good to go.
In Sweden, the microchips are already here.
The microchip implants use the same technology that's in contactless credit cards.
Which have made cash pretty much obsolete in Sweden.
No cash.
At this tech fair, a chipping event for those on the cutting edge, merging their hands with this new technology.
I thought it would be fun, right?
The process is simple and swift. A pinch of the skin, and in a matter of seconds, the chip is inserted. The transformation is complete. As for the pain,
I barely felt it.
But even in this nation of early adopters, not everyone is racing to get chipped.
Feel less human. I will feel like a robot.
I mean, it's so much more data can go into this, you know, when it's in your body.
There's no central registry tracking how many people are chipped, but biohacker Hannes Wellblood estimates between 5 and 10,000.
In the future?
All right, family, I'm going to stop it there. I'm going to put a link in the description box, and family, you can read it. There's another one about this. I think I mentioned the digital currency already. Yeah, so family, this is all part of the new system that they're about to implement. Build back better, the world reset. But family, through the spirit, we've been seeing the only reset that is coming is Yahawashi's reset. That's right. Because he told us in Job 20. Let me get that quickly. Job 20, where he says he's about to fill his belly. Is it Job 20 or 20? Bear with me, family. Job 20:23. It reads, let's go, Job 20:23. Just these things should comfort you, family. Job 20:23. It says, when he is about to fill his belly, when he thinks his world, new world order is about to take off, family, listen to what the Lord is going to do. The Most High shall cast the fury of his wrath upon him and shall rain it upon him while he's eating. He's never, this thing here is never going to take off. But family, back to our lesson. Let's go to the book of Revelation. Revelation chapter 13. It said it. The Lord left us with everything, family. Revelation chapter 13, verse 16, it says here. Let's pick it up from 14. And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. And he causes all. The image of the beast is obviously his system. Okay. His rulership, from his government, politics, religion. These are all part of his image. This is what made him great. Right? But now there's one thing that he has to do. He needs to get control of the people. He wants to track you. He wants to know when you wake up, how you're feeling today, and what is wrong with you. He wants to know everything there is to know about you. He's trying to play the Most High Yahawah, Bahasham Yahawashi. That's why he's about to put that CHIP in you. The karagma is called. Here it says, verse 60, and he causeth all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark. Family, let's go to the blue letter so we can actually break it down. Let's go to Revelation 13, 16. So we can look up that word mark. Here it says, actually, you know what though? Let me go to the NLT. Let's get another. Here it says, Revelation chapter 13, verse 16 says, he required everyone, small and great. Small and great. Doesn't matter what side of society you are in, everybody have to take it. Rich and poor, free and slave, to be given a mark on the right hand or on the forehand. Family, let's look at some of this mark here. I brought, where are they? Here, these are some of the marks, family. They can put it anywhere. Your head. And guess what's going to be attached to this here? QR code. You're going to have a special QR code, family. You become part of his system. So now, you have abandoned your power, Yahawah. Now you are worshiping the creature that the creator creates. That's what this man is about to do. He wants everybody to worship him, because he now thinks he is the Most High. As soon as you take that, you now, he owns you. That's his mark. This is how proud these people are. But like I said, this time around, they forgot what the Lord did to Pharaoh in Egypt. But this time around, they're going to know who the power of Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi. They're going to know his power. Our Lord, our power, Yahawah. This nations, the fear that the Lord is about to put in their heart, they will never forget it. This is the image the Lord is telling you not to take. Our Lord Yahawah, through his only begotten Son, our Redeemer Yahawashi, is coming for us. But this is what have to happen. This is one of the prophecy that have to happen before the Third World War. And that is also coming. These are the two major prophecies, family. And I'm here to tell you through the Spirit, this is not for you. That is why Ezekiel, again, let's go to Ezekiel. Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 17 says here, straight to the point. Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore, hear the word at my mouth and give them warning from me. This is warning. Warning, this is not for you. Our kingdom is the one coming. Lord willing, is the one coming after this one here. And you don't want to be turned into a barbecue on this end, because the Lord Yahawah Bahasham is sending his only begotten Son and the angel to come and destroy this place. If you take that, you'll be turned into a barbecue. And here it says, and he causeth all, both small and great, to receive a mark in their right hand or their forehead. Let's look up that mark. It's karagma. Where is it? here. This is the Greek word.
Strong's G, 5480. Charagma. Charagma.
Charagma. Show strong info. A scratch or etching. Example, stamp as a badge of servitude. You hear that, family? Servitude. Or sculptured figure, statue, graven mark. You hear that, family? It's a servitude. So once you take this now, you're telling the Most High Yahawah Bahasham that he doesn't own you anymore. That you are now in the hands of these devils. You rather serve the creature than serve the Most High Yahawah Bahasham. That's exactly what you are telling our power, Yahawah. So this year is not for you. This is the warning from the Most High Yahawah. Bahasham Yahawashi, his only begotten son, family, the Lord has blessed us tremendously, family. At one point, we had no clue who we are. Family, we were lost. Family, we were lost. Following everybody, every religion. But this is the last days. Why do you think the Lord is doing this for us? Because he loves us and doesn't want to see us get destroyed. That's why he has opened our eyes to wait on him. Yes, they're going to make things difficult for you. But don't forget, family, when these things are happening and you start thinking, because we live in this fleshly bodies. And yes, sometimes, you know, a doubt tries to creep in. We start to lose a little faith because we're thinking about how we're going to pay our mortgage, how we're going to pay our bills. What if we don't take it? What, family, I'm here to tell you through the Spirit. The Lord gave us many examples. He gave us, told us in the first book of Kings, chapter 17. He fed Elijah. You know how he fed Elijah? At one point, there was a drought in the land for 3 years. You know how he fed Elijah? He sent the ravens to bring food to Elijah every day. Family, on our way in the wilderness, when we started complaining to Moses about, oh, we should have stayed in Egypt, complain about our food, the Lord sent us angel bread, manna, sent us quail, beautiful meat. Family! So if the Lord did it back then, what did Romans says? That's why Apostle Paul said it. He says these things were written for our... Well, let me get it before I butcher it. Well, let's go to the book of Romans. Family, we're just flowing with the Spirit. I'm not going to be long with this lesson. Romans, is it 15:4? Yes. For whatsoever, bracket Yahawah Bahasham Yahawashi, it says, for whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we, through patience and comfort of the scriptures, might have hope. Family, because we know what the Lord did for our people back in those days, so we are about to face similar issues. So guess what Apostle Paul told us? He goes, listen, these things here should comfort us. That's what was written. To comfort us in the time of trouble. So if the Lord can feed Elijah, he sent food to Elijah by the ravens. The ravens brought Elijah food. Can you imagine? Can you really wrap your head around it? This is what the Lord did. This is what Apostle Paul also reminding us. This is what these things here were written. So through what? It says, were written aforetime. Were written for our learning. That we, through patience and comfort, you see the word is patience and comfort, patience. Temptations are coming. They are coming. We all have to go through it. But are we going to have the patience to wait for our Lord to send his angels? Because the angels are here. Family, they are here with us, cheering us on. Come on! They are cheering us on. These things should comfort us. Family, we want these what is it called? These prophecies to be jumping off the pages. We want them to bring it. We said, bring it. Bring it, because we want to go home. The faster these things happen, the sooner we get out of this place. That's our faith. So family, it's not for us. We are not taking part in their system. You see, it is a mark. So once you take it, it's a badge. Now you are a servitude. You're saying, yes, I will be a slave to you, for you, forever. But this is not for us. This is the hour of temptation. We are going to go through it. Let's go with Revelation 14:9. Let's hear what the Lord have to say about those who take it. Revelation 14, verse 9. It says, and the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image, I show you the image already, it's like the grain of rice, and receive his mark. Sorry, the mark is like the grain of rice in his forehead or in his hand, family. It says here, verse 10, Revelation 14:10. It says, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of the Most High, family. And here it says, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation. And he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and the presence of the Lamb. Family, think about it. As you've been barbecued, the angels are up in the chariots and looking down with the elect, looking down at you. It says, look at this. Because you want to live comfortably in this world. We only have like, what, 2 weeks here? I'm just using that as a term. Family, the time here is short. Nothing is worth this. No. Then you can give you $1 billion. Family, it's not worth it. Because we are about to inherit a kingdom. A kingdom. An everlasting kingdom. Lord willing. So this year is not for us. It's not for us, family. It's not for us. We have to wait patiently. That's what Paul says. Romans 15:4. These things were written. The Lord fed us everywhere we were. Finally, he will feed us. Don't worry about it. So what? So you lose your house somehow, some way. You might be walking and then somebody will say, yeah, come here. It could be an angel. He says, come here. No, this house is empty. I want you to stay here. That is what we are. Family, these are the things that we meditate on. We are expecting miracles. That's right. Expecting miracles. And that's the mindset that we have to be in. You have to have the faith and believe that the Lord is about to do some amazing things for his people, the elect. So family, like I said, I don't want this thing to be long. I'm going to end it there. Yes, it is a physical mark, charagma. It's not for us. They're going to make it convenient. Oh, you know what? There are so many stolen identities and how these people are. It's easier to track, you know what I mean? All you need is just this thing here and everything is going to be, you don't have to carry your keys, you don't have to do this, you have to do this, your driver's license, everything. No, family, it's not for us. It's not for us. This is not our kingdom. We were only here to serve our time. And family, our time is up. We have served our time. Eh? We are waiting for that gate to open so we can taste freedom. So this is not the time to start getting, you know, compromising yourself. And then the next thing you know, you are stuck in the place that you are trying to get out of. No, it's not for us. So family, with that, we give honor and glory to our power, Yahawah Bahasham, Yahawashi Bahasham, Kakudash. Yes, our Father has not forgotten us. And this is warning to the elect. This trip is not for us. We're going to wait on our Lord. He's the one that's going to rise up to the prey. With that, I say shalom. Shalom to the beloved of Israel. Shalom.